What up, you beauties? As promised, I'm going to show you how I filmed and edited the video for door dashing. Now, with regards to what I used film-wise, boom, is right down here. And as you can see, it's angled up quite a bit, but when I'm over my bike, it's pretty well bang on. And that's really what I had to do with the chest mount. And why did I use a chest mount? I have a handlebar mount and helmet mount and, well, other mounts as well. The bar mount is absolutely rattly as can be, and the imaging is not very fluid. The helmet mount, or like a sticker mount, is absolutely phenomenal. The body mount, I thought, just made the most sense because it wasn't as out there, if you will, when I was cruising around through the city. And it's a decent POV that was easy to work with, and I didn't have to fight really at all. Let's get to it though. We're going to break down into the software and pulling up clips and showing you how they're cut. And I take a lot of clips as opposed to a long video to make editing that much easier.
First and foremost, guys, I'm sorry. This was supposed to be up on Saturday, but not to worry. We're still posting. It's a little something on Wednesday. Now, first things first, I usually wait a little bit to talk. That way you can actually hear me. Previously, I would actually speak too soon and maybe forget the beginning of the clip. So I have to take a double cut. But all I'm really doing here is cropping it and, cutting out the parts I don't need. This is all done in Shotcut, which I have found to be really the easiest to get used to, simply because it's free, and there's a lot online in terms of help and tutorials. If you don't know how to do something, it's very easy to find out how to do it, simply because, well, somebody will show you. And in this video, the one thing I didn't actually use at all were the, transitions, which are nice to have, and the nice thing about them is it does give you a few options to work with as opposed to, having to fight them. Not to say that that's the case in any software, but this is what I'm used to, which has been pretty easy. Another thing, really, too, in terms of clips, like I was saying, I usually try to shoot short ones. Generally, 5 minutes is kind of the high, but as you can see, turn that off right there. Now, when it comes to editing clips or adding clips, if you want a clip playing on top of a clip, you can, or an image on top of one, you can. It's just that you have to start another video track. And then in terms of its sizing, its orientation, whether it's instantly visible or is faded in and faded out, you have a lot to play with. And position-wise, take a little bit for me. But really, it's just lack of consistently putting images on top of a video. So all I'm aiming for here is the bottom right corner, but I wasn't really too sure how much it was going to move and what was really going to work. So with a few number changes, it does move over to get right in that corner. And this gent here is actually on the Red Blacks in Ottawa and is dropping some tracks, so I figured I'd toss it in this video because really, audio is a big one too, and this is one that I was debating actually in general to use in this video. But audio tracks are easy as well. All you have to do is add another track, an audio track, and then pick whatever MP3 you want and pop it in there. And then in terms of that, you still have lots to change. You can change the clip length, you can actually slow it down, speed it up, fade in, fade out. And this is the beauty of Shotcut, at least on my computer. This is my laptop though, not the computer I built in a video. But whenever you're doing a video and then audio or video on a video, it takes a lot out of your computer in terms of, it needs a lot of power. And let's just say my laptop doesn't really have a sufficient amount to take part in that. So it slows right down. And when that comes into play, I usually like to do partial export. By that I basically mean I'll export, a part of the video that I'm trying to make and get it in there and then export, listen to it, check it, and really, if I wasn't so lazy, I would just do it on my actual computer. But here it is, playing through.
Putting the phone mount to work. So, we're now at Lansdowne, this lovely area here, which is more or less a hotspot, at least a point to wait to hopefully get an order. But they just changed. So we are actually gonna head down to Rito and see kind of how many orders we get today.
And now we're like molasses, fresh out of fridge. So here it is all zoomed out. You can see obviously how long the clip was, and we are exporting the video, which is on blast. This is actually multiplied by, I think, 20. So pretty quick.
What up, beauties? Here's the full edit. We're on the bike.
Enjoy.
And we're putting the phone mount to work. So, we're now at Lansdowne, this lovely area here, which is more or less a hotspot, at least a point to wait to hopefully get an order. But they just changed. So we are actually gonna head down to Rito and see kind of how many orders we get today. Can't let the kids starve at home. No more stress, no more stress. No, you gotta keep pressing. Well, it's been an hour and an hour and a half, and we still ain't got nothing. We don't even have one, but you know what, we still got 2 hours to go, so let's keep our fingers crossed and hopefully we get one. But for the time being, we're obviously exploring the streets. We got some nice pictures back here and people walking the dogs, but let's keep on keeping on.